This is another down and dirty video about how to put hardy board backer into a shower that is utilizing an acrylic shower pan. So this is a Delta acrylic shower pan. I've done the install on that. You can see I've got it connected to the stud walls with screws. I have also gone ahead and put silicone on each screw just to extra watertight that part of it there. And what we're going to do now is we're going to talk about putting the hardy board backer against the walls and how to go install that correctly, not getting any potential moisture up through the lip and wicking up the hardy board itself. So this is the shower pan, and it's already been installed. Again, I've put silicone over the screws that I've installed it with. But the question now is, how should the hardy board backer, which is what I'm going to attach the tile to, how should it meet this, the actual shower pan? Now, I've just got a piece of hardy board here, so I'll just use this as an example. There are some that say you should go this high and then simply caulk that gap. Some say you should put it right on the top and then silicone along the bottom. By the way, I meant silicone. And some say you should put it down on the ground like this and then just silicone this gap. Well, there's problems with option number three, this one, of course, because silicone will eventually fail. And no matter how much you waterproof this, it's going to start to leach up, get in behind. And of course, you've got studs, insulation. It's going to get that wet. Of course, if you do this model here, where you keep a little bit above the lip, you're going to have the same problem with water wicking, because that silicone is going to fail, and eventually water is going to get in there, and that's going to cause a problem as well.
Let me interject with a quick clarification here. So I demonstrated the three different positions that I found that people said you should put the hardy board on, but I'm really going to be talking about both the positioning of the hardy board, but more importantly, what should be behind the hardy board, because that was what I was struggling to find out. And this is the solution that I came across that I thought made the most sense. So it will be both about how to position the hardy board inside of the pan, and what you do behind it to make sure that you stop any water from getting into the studs and to the wall cavity.
So I looked at a lot of different options, and there was one solution that I saw that made the most sense. That's what I want to share. So this product, I got this at Home Depot. It's made by a company called Protecto Wrap. It's called Window, Door, and Ceiling Tape. It's a self-adhesive tape that rolls out, in this case, I don't know how many feet this is, but it's quite a bit. And this is a fairly, this is 9 inch from top to bottom. And the concept that I heard that made a lot of sense was that you put this down and put it over the lip, about halfway over the lip, and you do that all the way around. So what you'll have now is this plastic adhesive that goes from here and goes up the wall this high. Then the concept is, after you're done with this, you come back with a fairly heavy mill plastic, and you go, in this case, up about 3 feet high and down and overlap over top of this, in this case, this window and door self-adhesive ceiling or sealant tape. And what you then have is a waterproof barrier that's adhered to this lip here that goes up, and then another heavy layer of plastic that goes here, and you literally have a double barrier protection. Then you put your hardy board on top of that. Then you go ahead and you do your water sealing and your mesh tape and everything. And what you have now, a pretty tight seal, waterproof seal, that will eliminate water from going in. So I'm going to do that, and then I'll show you what that looks like. Okay, so we've installed the one side here. Again, I'm just going to show you the one side. It should be sufficient to explain the concept. But so I put this down. Now, this, again, has two sides to it. I'll show it to you here. It comes like this. This, of course, is the non-adhesive side. This is the plastic or the paper that comes off, that peels off for you to access the black adhesive side. I'll just pull that a little bit so you can see how that looks. So obviously, the black adhesive side goes against the wall. I put it down, again, about a half inch from the bottom all the way along. And then, of course, I've just sealed it to the studs here. It's holding pretty good. It doesn't have to hold long because, of course, I'm going to come back over it with that plastic that will drape over top. I'll probably terminate the plastic here and then run it up about 3 feet. So now I have a really good moisture barrier all the way along. And then what I'll do is put the hardy board on top of that, and that will now give me a good solid protection. Okay, so I've now put the layer of plastic on. Again, I'm going to right about 3 feet up, went all the way around. It got up a little bit higher here, so I don't have the same amount of overlap that I wanted on the other side, but that's okay. It's still going to be well protected. And what's going to happen now is I'm going to put my backer board on, and the backer board will go over top of it like this. And I'll bring it down to about there and attach it. And then I'll have my good water barrier then that will stop any water that leaches through the backer board. We'll just go straight down and into the tub, and it should be totally fine, especially if I waterproof it like I'm going to. So okay, so this is the last video portion. I'll show just see how this worked out. I put the backer board in, kept it about half an inch above the base of the shower, the bottom. So it does go over the lip, but just a little bit. Got to do a little clean up on the edge, whatever. But overall, looks like it's in pretty good shape. Now, of course, I just have to go ahead and seal my joints with the thin set and do my waterproofing. So anyways, hope that helped you guys. Take care.
So I thought I would show you a few pictures of the rest of the project. You can see this is the waterproofing that I did. Again, I used the mesh tape on all of the seams, and I also put a special waterproof caulking on all of the screw holes. I then went ahead and did at least two coats, I think. In the bottom part, I did at least three. And then you can see where I was putting the tile in. This was 2-foot by 1-foot tile. And then the final picture is all the tile work completed, just needed to finish the grout. It has been working out great. I've had no problems with it, and I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. So thanks for watching, and again, I would appreciate you subscribing to my channel. That would help me out a lot. Take care, and good luck with your DIY.